So today we're doing some loose landscapes. They're not true to life. They're sort of just whatever colors I feel like. But I'm starting by taping out a grid with painter's tape on some Strathmore 500 series cold press paper. It's nowhere near as textured as Arch paper is, but I do like the texture of it. And it's what I have currently. So now that I'm taping out four sections, I've decided that what I'm going to do today is just use professional paints from big brands that I've got. So in the top left corner, I'm using the Schmincke Random Gray 2022 color. Which is one of my favorite paints. I don't use it all that often, but it is one of my favorites. Next is Roman Smalls. I have a number of them in my palette. I'm sort of just grabbing colors, but I will link the colors that I used below. The brushes I'm using are from Tintoretto currently, though. Later on, I do use some other brushes. Next is Daniel Smith. This is Undersea Green. My page was a bit wet. It spread more than I wanted it to, so now I'm trying to fix it. And then we've got blue. Apatite Genuine, I want to say, on top of it. A great blue color. Next to it, we have the White Knights paints. I haven't bought any recently, but because they're in my palette, I still use them. I feel like it's a waste to not use paints you already own. And I do enjoy the color payoff of them. So I decided to use them in this because they are one of the brands that I do have a bunch of in the professional series paints. Now we're going with some trees. Little happy trees. So this is a script or a liner brush. I don't know what brand it is. And some birds. Wasn't super happy with how that top one turned out. It was fine, but I think I could have probably gone in and darkened it more than I did. Getting these three colors to blend was so much harder than I thought it would be. I don't know if it was just the paper or the pigments or the amount of water, but they're definitely three colors I'm gonna have to play around with more because, like, theoretically in my head it worked. But it didn't really work on the page. And same thing with the Daniel Smith. I was having some issues. So I ended up going in with Mayan Blue Genuine, and that seemed to help at least a little bit. This is White Knight's Green Earth. I have multiple Green Earths in my palette. If you don't know, PG23 is one of the coolest pigments. Comes in so many different variations depending on where it was harvested, and I just love that little scene. I only ended up using three colors, but I think it's probably my favorite one just because of how simple it is. Now I'm trying to save this Daniel Smith one. I'm adding in Lunar Earth. I don't know, at this point it's quite dark, and I didn't want to add in black or neutral tint. And so I just sort of went for it. It's really dark. Go back to the Roman Smalls. And this is where, like, it was already not looking great. And then, like, my line work went a bit wonky. But we saved it. We put in some trees, we layered those trees. And then we went and we fixed that Perylene maroon by adding in Potter's pink, and a bit of the tree color that I'd mixed up with the, I think it was Shadow Violet Light and Misty Morning, and a bit of the Potter's pink was in it as well. I think I saved it in the end. Maybe there was also Indanthrone blue in it. It got better. It got less bad. Yeah, the hill was hard to save. What I do like about this paper is how cleanly tape pulls. Never seems to warp, and there's just something about the bottom right and top left and their simplicity that makes me really happy. I hope you enjoyed watching the longer painting version of these paintings.